RanTools version 1.1.0 has just been released and it has got a lot of new updates, and in this video I'll then run through all of them. So let's get started. The first and the biggest update is the new ambientCG material library. You can access the material library by pressing Alt plus N, and here you can search for any textures. Let's try a ground texture. There are 16 results on the first page. You can move to the next page by pressing this button. And let's try this material. Let's go for a 2K JPEG version. Once you click the download button, it will start downloading. And once that download is complete, the material will be set up automatically. All the materials that you download will be available for use offline. So let's try something from the offline section. As you can see, all these materials I have already downloaded. Let's try these metal plates, 4K JPEG. And as you can see, it was set up instantly because it was already downloaded. There is also a new node mix menu in the shader editor, so you can mix any two materials or mix a texture with another imperfection map. First, let's try mixing two materials. Simply select the node and press Alt plus M, and then you can choose the material you want to mix it with. Let's mix it with this grass material and use the noise texture as the mix factor. As you can see, they have been mixed. You can change the look of it by changing the scale and dragging these points. You can also mix imperfection maps with any other node. Simply select the node. For example, let's select this roughness map and Alt plus N, and let's mix it with this surface imperfection map. As you can see, they have been mixed. Instead of mixing, if you want to simply plug it into a socket, you can also do that. For that, simply select the node, press Alt plus N, and let's try these scratches. You have to hold on Alt while clicking, and then you can select the socket. So as you can see, it has been plugged into the roughness socket, and as you can see, there are scratches. The next update is regarding the debugger. There is now an option to add a new bevel modifier after the boolean. Let me show you using this cube as an example. Let's draw a box and press Ctrl plus B to add a new bevel. As you can see, you can control the out bevel with this. Using this, you can have different amounts of bevel for different cutters. Next, we have some updates for the modifier presets. So there's now a new bevel presets menu which you can access by pressing Alt plus D. Here you can store your most used presets like bevel, solidify, weight, or whatever. How this works is, if you want to add any preset to the favorites menu, you can simply hold on Alt while clicking on its name, and it will be added to the favorites menu. See, also you can remove it by doing the same thing, hold on Alt and click, and it will be removed. There are also a few updates for the modifier adjustment. As you can see, there is now a list of modifiers on the left, and you can move to the next modifier by pressing W, or move to the previous modifier by pressing Q. All the adjustable properties of the modifier now get their own keys, so you don't have to cycle using A. You can simply press S or D for profile or angle limit in case of bevel, or S for offset in case of solidify modifier, and similar for all other modifiers. You can also press Z or X to quickly multiply or divide the value by 2. So you can simply do this. Next, we have a small update for the backup manager, and that is, now all the objects are their own collection of backups, so they are better organized in the outliner, as you can see. You can now use any other object for normal transfers. For that, you have to hold on Alt while clicking on the normal transfer button. It will automatically unhide all the hidden objects, and you can select whatever the object you want to use as a source. There is now also a flip checkbox which you can use to flip the source normals, so let's do that, and as you can see, you get perfect shading. Focus scroll in the camera adjust has been replaced with a focus picker. You can now copy and paste the colors to all the lights of the group by pressing this button. You can now clear split normal data by holding down Ctrl and clicking on Shades mode.